In this video, I will be making this aluminium air battery 4.5 volts. So let's get started. First, you will be needing these black little things. These are carbon brushes from electric motors, and I have lots and lots of them. Now, in my previous video, I used graphite powder, because of which its resistance was high, since it was neither compressed nor strongly bonded when compared to a solid carbon brush. So for a single carbon plate, I will be using 4 of these brushes and 2 zip ties. So one carbon terminal is ready, let's make 2 more. Now if we check the resistance of these carbon plates, 7.5, 8.3, 8.5, so you can see that it is very low this time. Remember that graphite leaves black mark if you touch it, so wear your gloves if you want. This what you see is a 3D printed case for the air battery that I'm making. So starting with the carbon plates, which will go in as shown. You see there are small compartments and in total 3 cells. So now comes the aluminium plates, and I need 3 of them. Now take a black wire and connect it to the last aluminium plate. This is going to be your overall negative. Next, take a red wire and connect it to the last graphite or carbon plate. This is going to be your overall positive. After making the connections, don't forget to do the continuity check to make sure correct operation. After that comes my new LED cob lights, 3 watts that I've got from DF Robot. Links for them have been provided in the description. You can check them out. So now that everything is almost complete, it is time to make the electrolyte, that is distilled water that I'm using. Next is the potassium hydroxide. That should be enough. Time to connect the multimeter for measuring voltage. Here I'm going to use this red wire, positive. So that's connected. And if I touch it here like this, you see 0 volts. It is time to fill in the electrolyte now. What is needed? Yeah, now the cell is filled. Connecting it to the aluminium wire, and here we have 1.5 volts. That is amazing. It's the maximum that I've got yet. Let's fill the others as well. That's done. The last one. Yeah, it's complete. Now measuring the overall voltage, and here we have 4.5 volts for the first time. My new aluminium air battery. It's amazing. 4.5 volts. That is huge, guys. This test is going to prove a lot for my future research and experiments if I'm going to do it. Now I have this gob light that I just prepared. Let's connect it and see if we can light this one up. It has 3 watts. Okay. Wow. Brilliant. Let's turn off the lights. So all the lights are turned off. Turning it on now. Oh, it is beautiful. Amazing how the battery is working. See, so nice. I am so happy with the results. Trying the white LED. It should be brighter than the others, but let's try it anyways because it is going to take a little more current than the others as well. Okay, you see, turning off the lights, and here we have, wow, it is indeed brighter than the others, and our battery is working really good. Nice. I'm not sure the color of this gob light. Let's try it and we will see. It's purple. This one is the dimmest. I don't know why. This one, let's see. We have the red one. Okay. See, red. I wanted to test the blue one, but I'm not sure where it is. Oh, it is the green. A link for these gob lights has been provided in the description. You can buy it from there. It's beautiful. I think I should turn off the lights again. It's much brighter now. Amazing. My fully working air battery. Very soon I'm going to try the 12 volts air battery plus eliminating further errors that I might find. It is a progress indeed. So this is the blue one I've been looking for. It's beautiful. That's the battery. The battery is very powerful, although the only drawback is that it is not rechargeable because it's a fuel cell. Aluminium is going to get consumed and you will have to replace the plates. The rest is good. It's beautiful. So this time I'm going to use this comparatively bigger DC motor because my battery is also bigger this time. I should easily run it and go. Wow. It's quite nice. That's a Swiss motor. Working great. So I would say that aluminium air battery has a great future ahead, and I am not going to stop working on it. Planning to build a big enough battery in my coming videos, so you surely have to stay connected if you are interested in this kind of stuff. Now this one is a 24 volts pump motor. It's quite big, but I think that the starting current should be enough to run it. Whoa, as expected, it is running very slow because this is 48 volts motor and I'm feeding it with only 4.5 volts. So it is starting, but it's not fast enough. It is running, that in itself is a big deal. Now it is time to measure the short circuit current that this battery is actually producing, milliamperes. Okay. So here we have 65 milliamperes. That is way too less. I think there is a situation here. Oh, the electrolyte is getting out somehow. I'm not sure how, but it is. Amps are very less. So here I'm going to add potassium hydroxide flakes.
two flakes. Yeah, now let's check the current. You can see the current has increased to 80 milliamperes, although the fact is that I had hoped for more. Seems like the concentration is way too less and I can do much better here. It's great that I just tested this, the amperes. So I'm going to put back the electrolyte, my solution, since I'm not very satisfied with the ampere results. Now with that being done, let's add twice more flakes. Let's go a little more. So we are doing around 2.3. Mixing it well and putting it back as it was before. And that's it. It's time to test the amperes now. 124 milliamperes, you see. 117, and obviously it is a short circuit, so it is consuming much more current. 121. So increasing the quantity of potassium hydroxide flakes in water is going to increase the flowing current, but there has to be a limit to which the current can increase. Obviously, everything has a limit. So guys, that's all for today's video. See you in the next one. Stay connected. Bye bye.